Love that. Anyways, next up is Captain Falcon from F-Zero. His alternate costumes include a darker Captain Falcon, which could be based off of one of the villain characters in F-Zero X, Black Shadow. There's also one directly based off of Captain Falcon's main rival, Blood Falcon. And another, a pink one, a fan favorite, based off of another F-Zero racer, Jody Summer. So yeah, we'll just stick with the... there actually is one more Captain Falcon alternate costume. And actually, there are two more, now that I think about it, that we'll only be able to see in the multiplayer mode. But for now, we'll go with the default. Alright, so Captain Falcon is a pretty cool character because, like I mentioned before, he comes from a racing game, or a racing game series, the F-Zero games. So you don't really see him much outside of his car in those games. So how do they make a moveset for him out of that for a fighting game? Well, they actually decided to completely make up a moveset for him in this game. And because of that, he has some of the most iconic moves in the entire series. Mainly with his specials. And his neutral special, probably being his most famous, again, completely being made up for this game, is the Falcon Punch! Literally just a fiery punch with a flame in the shape of a falcon. That is amazing. There's also his down special, the Falcon Kick, which is just as cool, if not cooler. Come on, there we go. There's also his up special, which is where he grabs an opponent and just kind of just throws them while shouting, yes. Absolutely incredible. See why Captain Falcon's so beloved now? I don't think he would be as much if it weren't for Smash Brothers. So, yeah, we can thank this game for kind of kickstarting the true popularity of the character. It's also interesting to note that the stock icons at the bottom, I don't think I really talked about those before. But yeah, each character has their own unique stock icon and even franchise logo behind the damage percentage, which is just kind of a logo that represents their franchise. So of course, like, but it's by franchise, not character. So Mario and Luigi share a logo, and Pikachu and Jigglypuff share a logo, which in Captain Falcon's case is logo is just kind of his own Falcon logo. And the same also applies for his stock icon. It's not a it's not like, you know, his head or whatever, like most other characters in this game, like Fox. It's just of the Blue Falcon. Which is really only seen in this game because they do change it in Smash Brothers Melee and Onwards to represent Captain Falcon's own head, because they got higher quality and with the other ones. Anyways, there's Captain Falcon's Break the Target stage. Of course, it makes sense for it to have the more futuristic ground terrain, especially since Captain Falcon comes from a futuristic racing game. Only makes sense. There we go. Gonna need to use a lot of the Falcon Punch in this game. Or in this stage. There we go. I wonder if we can... Will we be able to reach it? No. Alright, I have an idea. Nice, we can get both of those with the same attack. Okay, that was just the wrong input. I meant to do an up special there, but that didn't work. Stupid analog stick. Always confusing me with the four main directions and four extra in-between directions, of course. Although I guess I should be thankful it has the slants, because with more modern controllers, there's just none at all on the edge of the analog stick, which just makes things even more confusing, especially for a game like this, which requires precise analog stick inputs. Come on. Yeah, because of how long it takes to charge up the Falcon Punch, it's really hard to actually pull it off, but when you do, it is extra satisfying. That was disappointing. Uh-oh. Yeah, also, with the F-Zero franchise, after the Nintendo 64 game, there would only be three more F-Zero games, with only one more major installment, that being F-Zero GX for the GameCube. Oh, by the way, I also forgot to talk about Captain Falcon's taunt, which I'll discuss later, after I talk about the state of the F-Zero franchise. Oh my god. But yeah, after F-Zero X on Nintendo 64, there was F-Zero GX for GameCube and two Game Boy Advance games. Which I believe were F-Zero GP Maximum Velocity and... what was the other one called? F-Zero... F-Zero Crisis? Something like that? And that was released in 2004. That was the last F-Zero game we ever got. And I want to think it's because of Smash Brothers. It might be the main reason why people are so clamoring for a new F-Zero game. Because otherwise it would have been another one of Nintendo's forgotten franchises. But the fact that Captain Falcon was one of the original 12 Smash Brothers characters, it kind of put F-Zero on the radar more. And that's kind of the power of Super Smash Brothers, is that it can be more pop... It's become so popular that it can become more popular than franchises featured in it. And I've talked about this before, but it's so apparent with franchises like Fire Emblem, Kid Icarus, the Mother games, just Earthbound, F-Zero, would I see Pikmin? Oh no, maybe not. But I guess Metroid can also apply to that. Because, you know, there wasn't a Metroid game on Nintendo 64. But considering, I don't know if Metroid Prime would have come out if it weren't for Smash Brothers. It might have. Anyways, I also forgot to mention that Captain Falcon is a pretty fast character. So, there's going to be a lot of horizontality with his board the platform stage. I think he's the fastest runner in the game. It makes sense. Although, I don't know how common it is for racers of fast vehicles to be fast themselves on foot. But here we are with Mr. Captain Falcon over here, who could easily become an Olympic athlete if he wanted to. see, can I maybe get a running start and then... Nope! Welp. Oh shoot, we got one of the Kirby hats being Captain Falcon's helmet. Here we go. We get to fight Kirby Falcon. I was gonna say Captain Kirby, but I don't know how well that or how well that kind of makes sense, you know. So earlier, I was going to mention Captain Falcon's taunt. As soon as I deal with these guys. Come on. Stupid Link, Kirby. Wow. That's just not funny. I swear, these guys. Well, when did the stage become so hard all of a sudden? It was easy before. Also, by the way, whenever an item like the hammer or the star, like, that changed the music, whenever it expires, the background music of the stage itself just resets. And this is the only game where that's the case. And Captain Kirby is gone. Kirby ranks. We got them down in order. Very nice. But there goes our no-miss streak, unfortunately. Where we went through stages without missing or losing a single stock. It will be missed. Missed. Because it's no miss, whatever. There we go. Okay, I don't even know where that Pokeball went. Anyways, Captain Falcon's taunt is him saluting and saying, "Show me your moves." Another thing that was made up for this game and has become an iconic trait of Captain Falcon. Of him requesting his opponents to show him their moves. Ain't that nice? He's giving his opponents a chance, I see. He's not just gonna let them stand there and get punched by him. What a nice sport Captain Falcon is. Okay. What the heck is going on? Don't remember the opponents being this smart before. Is it because the game realizes I'm playing as Captain Falcon? So it's like, oh crap, he's playing as such a cool character. We gotta make the game a little harder for him. Because otherwise, he'd be too cool for the game itself. Too badass for the game itself. Gonna make things harder. Either that or I'm just not the greatest with Captain Falcon compared to other characters. Well, there we go. Of course I gotta spam show me your moves whenever I get the chance. Alright, let's see how he goes up against Metal Mario. Can his Falcon Punch go through literal metal? Probably. I mean, he has to go up against metallic cars all day, right? It's Seems to be working so far. Also, I want to say this game was also the first time that Captain Falcon was really given a voice, because, again, you don't really see Captain Falcon outside of his vehicle in F-Zero X. So, like, this might be the first time we really get to hear Captain Falcon speak. Well, kind of. Not, I guess he does speak, but not really in full sentences, you know. Except for show me your moves. Ooh, race to the finish. This should be easy. Out of the way, Polygon DK. Okay, that was smooth. Uh-oh. Oh shoot, it's Polygonal Captain Falcon. Was able to recognize some of his melee attacks. Alright, now is no time to mess around. If the last one player game taught me anything, it's that I gotta be careful with the items I pick up. I have 3 stock. I don't want to lose more from freaking explosive barrels or whatever, capsules, eggs, crates, whatever. In Super Smash Bros. Melee, there was another container item that was introduced. That one, despite being a lot more complex of an item, can sometimes, if thrown, will just explode. Not even do its little song and dance or whatever that it usually does. Just straight up explode. And nothing else. It's amazing. You see, a Bob-omb is easier to look out for, because it's like, that's a 100% guarantee it's gonna explode, you know? It's still just as annoying, but it's something that it's easier able to look out for. God, this is a maximum tomato. Alright. Nice. Now, I don't think I really talked about F-Zero on the Super Nintendo, which is, of course, where the franchise originated, because it was one of the games to really show off the Super Nintendo's hardware, to where the Super Nintendo had a kind of graphical setting called Mode 7, to where it was able to pretty much warp and rotate and stretch sprites to where they could have, like, they could have sprites and textures be laid out in a three-dimensional space, which allowed for games like racing games, along with other games that could have, you know, be more easily enjoyed in 3D perspectives to strive. That's why there were a lot of racing games. And that's why there were a lot of racing games on the Super Nintendo. And of course, it was a system where another popular Nintendo racing game franchise, dang it! It was also where Mario Kart got its start. which was a game that did a similar technique with the Mode 7. And there we go. We took care of Master Hand. And so, yeah, that is Captain Falcon. Full power. If they ever released a Captain Falcon action figure, because I would kill for one. Let's see. Special moves programming, eh? Alright. I believe we go over to the voices. Voice actors. Ryo Horikawa was who voiced Captain Falcon. So that's pretty cool. And he, I believe, continues to voice the character to this very day. As of the time of recording this. In Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, I believe he did voice him once again. Especially in... There were some character reveal trailers for that game. To where they actually got Horikawa to reprise his role as Captain Falcon, which I think is friggin' awesome. Even if that, I think, was just for a couple grunts. Super awesome. But yeah, that's the power of Captain Falcon right there. And here is his congratulations screen. Thank you for playing. Yes, I am number one. Well, that's not very nice. You're not gonna give me any credit? You're just gonna be the selfish one, call yourself number one? Even though I was the one controlling you, Falcon? By the way, the background here is actually taken straight from the alternate title screen of F-Zero X. So yeah, this screen pretty much consists of pre-existing art rather than them making unique art or just using the character model straight from this game. That's pretty interesting. There we go.